Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, insertion and action of the pronator teres muscle.
Here you can see an anterior view with the right arm, and you'll notice the pronator teres muscle highlighted in green. Just lateral to it, we have this muscle here, which is a brachioradialis muscle, and it's actually covering up the distal portion of the pronator teres. So the pronator teres is going underneath the brachioradialis here. Just medial to it, we have this muscle here, which is the flexor carpi radialis. Here we can see the pronator teres in isolation from an anterior view. And looking at it from this view, you might think that it just connects the humerus to the radius, but it's actually got two points of origin, another point of origin on the ulna. So let's swap to a more medial view so we can take a look at that. Now we can more easily see the two heads of the pronator teres, and we've got the ulnar head here and the humeral head up here. And you will notice there's a gap between the two heads, and this gap is where the median nerve passes through. Now one thing to note is if there's a narrowing of this gap, that can cause compression of the median nerve and lead to something called pronator teres syndrome. Now we can see those origins marked out in red. Let's take a look at the ulnar origin first, which is right here, and that's on the coronoid process of the ulna. As for the humeral head, we've got that up here, and that's originating on the medial supracondylar ridge of the humerus. The supracondylar ridge is going to be a ridge which begins on this medial epicondyle and then comes up the humerus here. Next, we can see the insertion marked out here in blue, and that's on the mid shaft of the radius, just offset towards the lateral side.
So let's have a look at the actions next. The first one is one you might have already guessed, and that's because the action is in the muscle's name. So we've got the forearm in a supinated position now, and as pronator teres contracts, it's going to turn it over into a pronated position. So pronation of the forearm is our first action, and it's also the most primary action of this muscle. As well, it's coming up the forearm here, and it's crossing over the elbow joint. So its contraction can result in a flexion of the elbow joint. But it's only going to be an assistive role because we have more primary flexors of the elbow joint. In the forearm, we have the brachioradialis muscle. And in the upper arm, we have the biceps brachii and the brachialis. If you'd like to see information on any of them, check out the description box below. I'll put links to that video. So if you've enjoyed the video or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press those buttons down there because it really helps out the channel. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. I'll see you all next time.